So hi, good evening everybody. This is our second session. I'm starting here. The session will be today. I'll cover only problems. Okay. I'll be covering problems on transformer. So let us wait for some 1 or 2 minutes so that other students can also join. Okay. So in the last session, I completed third unit completely. Transformers and induction motors. Okay. So and as usual, rules and protocols will be same at the end. And before ending the video, you all have to give your attendance by typing your rule number and your branch in the comment section. That is very, very important. Okay. Commenting with your rule number and branch in the comment section. Don't forget to do that. Not at the end, you can do it in any time, either starting, middle, or end. Okay, but that is not important. Important thing is I want you to see the complete video. Okay, theory I can give you the notes, but problems I already told you, problems will not be shared. Problems you have to note down. Okay, today I'll solve problems only 4 or 5 problems on the transformer. Before that, I'll be giving you a list of formulas you have to note down in the notebook. Because without formulas, you cannot solve the problems. You don't solve the problems, you'll not understand the problem. Don't understand the problem, as usual, you'll not pass. Because to pass PWE, you have to solve the problems in exam. Okay. Now, I'll be starting session. My session I'll be starting. I'll start my session with list of formulas. So all of you, please carry the notebook with you along with the pen, notebook, and calci also Rick mask. In class, you will not bring. At least in your home, you should have calci, you know. Right now, everybody is sitting in your home. So, bring the calci from your home. Sit in front of the video with calci, notebook, and pen. Okay. We'll start the problem now. Before that, write down the list of formulas. So, all of you write down the list of formulas. First list of formulae you have to write. Everyone, please write down the list of formulas. I'll be dictating you one by one. Okay. So first formula will be to write down list of formulas. So list of formulae. We are doing problems on transformers. Those who are joining now, for them I am telling one more time, problems on transformer. Okay, so problems on transformer. For more clear visual, I'm switching on the light, which is not required. I can switch off also. I think this is not required. Okay, sure. So first formula, write down everybody. First formula, EMF equation of transformer is given by E1 is equal to 4.445 m. F N1 and E2 is equal to 4.445 m F N2. So this is the formula of EMF equation. Two EMF equations we have, as you already know, two windings means two EMF equations. So here phi m denotes maximum flux. Okay, then N1 primary winding, N1 primary winding, N2 secondary winding, for one section some problems I have covered already. For CS section I have covered problems, but don't worry, one more time you practice these problems, because same problems I am not doing here, different problems I am doing. It will be more practice for you people, those who already did the problem in CSC. It is like revision for you people. Okay, no loss is there. The more problems you solve, more knowledge you get here. Next, F will be frequency. These are the denotions of all the terms which are there in the formula. Okay, abbreviations of all the formula. Then E1 is primary EMF or primary voltage. E1 is primary voltage, E2 is secondary voltage. Right? E2 is secondary voltage. Next, second formula, you have to write KVA rating is equal to V1 I1 divided by 1000. This formula is very important. Okay. KVA rating is equal to V1 I1 divided by 1000. Similarly, V2 I2 1000. Okay, this is for primary side and this is for secondary side. Depending upon the need in the problem, we have to use the formula. Okay, two formulas, V1 I1 by 1000, V2 I2 by 1000. Next, third formula, flux density BM is equal to phi M divided by A. Okay. This is another formula, flux density. Here BM is nothing but flux density. BM is called as flux density, phi you already know that, maximum flux. A is nothing but area here. Here A denotes area of the core. Area of the core, which is always in meter square. You know, unit of area is meter square. Okay. So this is also important formula. Flux density BM is equal to phi M divided by A. Then, okay, these three formulas you should remember. One more ratio, transformation ratio. K is equal to V2 by V1 is equal to N2 by N1. This is equal to I1 by I2. This is also we have to use. So these formulas you should remember. So once again, everybody note down these formulas. I'll be giving you 2 minutes. If it is not properly visible, means please tell me in the comments so that I can adjust the camera here. Okay. Note down these formulas. I am dictating, you have to note down parallelly with me. It is not like classroom, so that I will be giving the time in classroom. No, to note down in board. Different. We have to be somewhat fast here. I have to cover. No? Okay. So these three form formulas are very, very important. You should remember. Okay. So we'll start first problem. You have to note down along with me, right? So I'll be keeping this aside for reference purpose. Whenever we need formula, we can use that. So here first formula is there. Sorry, first problem is written. You can see this. I'll read out the problem. First problem is a 550 kVA 2200 bar 440 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer has primary turns of 200. Determine first one flux in the core, secondary turns, third one is rated primary current, fourth place is rated secondary current. Okay, so what he has asked in the given problem, once again I'll read out. You can see this problem. A 50 kVA 2200 bar 440 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer has primary turns 200. Determine flux in the core, second one secondary turns, third one rated primary current, second one is rated secondary current. So in the first we'll note down what are the given values in the problem, then we'll go for what he has asked to find out. First, we'll note down what are the things he has given. First, write down the given data, solution. Okay, given. What are the values given? A 50 kVA is telling. So, kVA he has given. So, kVA is equal to 50. Then next, 2200 bar 440 volt he has written. So, it is like these are voltages. So, always first one will be E1, second one will be E2. Okay, in the problem, always they will be giving E1 by E2 ratio only. So E1 by E2, how much? 2200 divided by 440. So in this case, E1 will be how much? 2200 volt, and E2 will be how much? 440 volt. Okay, so these are the given voltages, primary and secondary. Next, what he has given? He has given 50 hertz. He has given, so F is equal to how much? 50 hertz. Next, primary turns of 200. He is telling primary turns. So in the formula, primary turns means N1 is denoted with primary. Therefore, N1 also has given. N1 is equal to 200 turns. Now these are the given values. KVA has given, E1 he has given, E2 he has given. Then next, what he has given? Frequency. Once again. Is it clear now? It is clear now. Now also it is not clear. I can see probably you check your camera clarity. Here it is appearing very clear now. Okay. Chalo. I have to hold the camera in one hand and I have to write from another hand. Some kind of distance will be there. Okay. You have to manage this. So now it is better, I think, somewhat. Right? Sure. So here, these are the given values. So now, first, what he has asked you to find out? First, flux in the curve. Flux means phi. So phi, you all know how to find out phi. Phi, to find out phi, you have one formula, that is Bm divided by A. So let us see whether this is given. No, this is given. No, so this problem will not work out. Think any other formula we have, so that using that we can find out the flux. One more formula we have, that is EMF equation. Write down that EMF equation. E is E1 is equal to 4.445 F N1. So here see, E1 is given, yes. F is given, yes. Phi is given, phi only we have to find out. N1 is given, primary turns, yes, he has given. So this is given, this is given, this is also given. So we can directly find phi. No, convert this equation into phi. Therefore, phi is equal to E1 divided by 4.44 F into N1. Okay, so E1 is how much? 2200. 4.44. F is how much? 50 hertz. N1 is how much? 200. So if you solve this, how much you will get? Obviously, I know nobody has carried calci because you are our students, no? ISL students. If anybody has brought the calci with him, kindly enter the values and tell me the answer. Okay. If anybody is carrying the calci, kindly enter and tell me the answer. What is the answer you got? 5 is equal to. So phi, after entering the values, after calculating, we'll get phi is equal to 0.0495 Weber. Unit of phi is Weber. Okay, good. Good, Nadeem. Okay, next, see here. So he calculated phi. Next, what is second one? He has asked secondary EMF. So secondary EMF
But secondary turns, N2 he has asked. Secondary turns means N2. N2 means, so how, what is the formula using which we can find out N2? One more EMF equation we have. That is, in place of E1, if you type E2, E2 is equal to 4.44 phi F N2. Phi we already calculated. That phi we can substitute here. And that whole equation you can write in terms of N2. This is one option. Another option is that you know transformation ratio. What is that? E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1 also you can use. Therefore, N2 is equal to N1 into E2, N1 into E2 divided by E1. Here N1 also you know, E2 also you know, E1 also you know. You can substitute these values. N1 is equal to how much? 200 turns. E2 is how much? Yes, given here, 2200. So 2200 divided by E1 is how much? E1 is also given. How much? 440. After calculating, what is the value of N2 you will get? How much? We'll get 40, I think. Okay. So N2 value will be 40. Next, 40 terms. Third one is, what he has asked in third one? See the problem. In third one, rated primary current. Rated primary current means I1. I1 is equal to, he has asked you. I1 is equal to how much? Yeah, correct, Tahaniyat, but 40.87 is fractional. We cannot take fractional number. So either you take 41. 40.87 means you take 41. Because if it is greater than 0.5 means next whole number we have to take. Transformation ratios cannot be in fractions. It's always whole number. Okay. You can make it a note. If it is getting 40.87 means 41 you write. If it is getting less than 0.5 means 40 you have to get. 40.44 means 40. Okay. What I have written is correct only. Okay. It means I am happy that students are responding. Students are responding. Chalo. Next, if response is good, we also get interest, encouraged to give more videos. Okay, because at least in your home you can study, not in the class means. Next, third one is rated primary current. Current is going to be I1. So primary means I1. If secondary current means I2. I1 you already know what is the formula. This is a formula. I1 is KVA rating is equal to KVA is equal to V1 I1 divided by 1000. So using this formula you can calculate I1. Therefore, I1 is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V1. KVA how much he has given? 50. 50 has given KVA. Therefore, 50 into 1000 divided by V1 is how much? 440. So how much you will get? I1. After calculating, you will get 22.7273. Okay, ampere. This is I1 value. Will get 22.73. Next, I2. What is the formula for I2? KVA into 1000 divided by V2. You can use this formula also, or you can use V2 by V1 is equal to I1 by I2 ratio, is it not? That also you can use. You can use any formula. It's up to you. So KVA into 1000 divided by V2. V2 value is 2200. After substituting this, you will get 113.6364 ampere. So this is I2 answer. I1 is equal to 22.72 and I2 is equal to 113.6364. Okay, so these are the values of I1 and I2. This completes the problem, right? The simple problem, they'll ask for 5 marks. Definitely one problem will be there from the EMF equation of transformer, right? It is for sure one problem will be there. So this is the easiest topic where you can score the problems, so where you can solve the problems and you can easily score the marks. Compared to all the units, transformer units problems are very easy. Okay, so try to follow at least this unit properly. This is first problem, simple problem. You should know how to use the formulas, where to use the formulas with respect to given problem. Everybody please note down this problem. 1 minute I'll be giving you. Next, we'll go for another problem. Same type only. You solve along with me. I'll be solving the problem slowly so that I'll be expecting the answers from you. At the end, anyway, I'll write the answers. Note down the problem. Single phase 2300/230 volt. Single phase. /230 volt, 50 hertz core type transformer. 50 hertz core type transformer has core section of 0.05 meter square. A single phase 2300/230 volt 50 hertz core type transformer has core section of 0.05 meter square. If the permissible maximum flux density is 1.11 Weber per meter square, if the permissible maximum flux density is 1.11 Weber per meter square. 1.11 Weber per meter square. Calculate the number of turns on the primary and secondary. Calculate the number of turns on primary and secondary. Calculate the number of turns on primary and secondary. So this is the problem. So again, after seeing the problem, read it carefully one times or two times, then try to note down the given values. Once you write down the given values, 20% of your work will be over. You'll come to know that what is given. Then first we'll write down what are the given values in the problem. Given values. So what he has given, a single phase 2300/230 volt. So I already told you the given ratio is always like E1 by E2. So E1 by E2 is equal to 2300/230. So E1 is 2300 volt, E2 is 230 volt. Next, what he has given, 50 hertz. So F is equal to 50 hertz. Next, core type transformer has core section of 0.05 meter square. Has core section means area he has given. Area is united with A. A is equal to 0.05 meter square. Area he has given. Then if the permissible maximum flux density is 1.11 weber per meter square. It means weber per meter square permissible flux density. What he has given? He has given flux density means BM. I already told you the list of formulas. BM is nothing but flux density. Flux density has given 1.11 weber per meter square. By seeing unit also you can identify that which quantity it is. If it is flux, it will be weber only. Weber per meter square is the unit of flux density, right? So BM he has given. So what he has asked, calculate the number of turns on primary and secondary he has given. So number of turns on primary, first N1 is equal to how much we have to calculate, then second N2 is equal to how much we have to calculate. So to calculate N1 and N2, what are the available formulas we have? That we have to check first. So first we have transformation ratio, V2 by V1 is equal to N1 by N2. Okay, V2 by V1 is equal to N2 by N1. We know V1, V2, but we don't know both. If anyone we know, we can use this formula. So this is, we can't use this formula. We can use EMF equation formula. So E1 is equal to how much? 4.445 FN1. So here again, using this one, we have to calculate N1. To calculate N1, F we need. F is given, S given. E1 is given, given. Flux is given, no. But first you identify flux. Once you know flux, you can calculate N1. If you know N1, using this formula, you can calculate N2. Okay. So let us identify flux first. You know one formula, flux density is equal to BM is equal to phi divided by A. A he has given, BM also has given. Using this formula, you can calculate phi. So therefore, phi is equal to BM into A. So BM is how much? 1.11. Then A is how much? 0.05. If you solve this, how much you will get? I'll wait for 30 seconds so that anyone can type here. Oh, very good. Are Nadim Sherman Sharif. Good. So 0.055 Weber is the answer. For flux is 0.055 Weber. So use this flux value in the EMF equation. So E1 is equal to, write this equation in terms of N1. Therefore, N1 is equal to E1 divided by 4.445 into F. E1 is how much? E1 is how much? 2300 divided by 4.445 is how much? Just now we calculated 0.055 into 50. If you solve this, you will get how much? 187. That is again whole number. 187 point something you will get. So if you round figure that, you will get 188. So N1 will be 188. Nadim has already shared the answer. Good. Similarly, you have to calculate N2. N2 is equal to E2 divided by 4.445 F. So 230 divided by 4.44 into 0.055 into 50. So you will get F2 is equal to, sorry, N2 you will get 19. So these are the answers of N1 and N2. You can also become topper, Abil. You also solve. For that you should have Calci. Okay. So everybody is topper according to me, right? So these are the answer values of N1 and N2. So N1 is 188, N2 is 19. Again, I'll be giving 1 minute. Those who have not noted down, please note down. And those who solved along with me, wait for some time. Okay. N1 will be 188, N2 will be 19. Next problem, I will dictate and I will wait for 5 minutes. Let us see, Abu Bali. You will answer the, you will write the, you will calculate and write the answers or not. Okay. You're telling match lik deru, match lik deru. I will give a chance to you to solve the problem and write the answer. Abu Ali. Okay. Next. Two problems are over. We'll take simple problem so that we can also solve this. This problem. Let us solve this problem. Okay. An ideal 25 kVA transformer has, note down this problem. An ideal 25 kVA transformer has An ideal 25 kVA transformer has 500 turns on the primary. An ideal 25 kVA transformer has 500 turns on the primary winding. 500 turns on the primary winding and 40 turns on the secondary winding. An ideal 250 kVA 25 kVA transformer has 500 turns on the primary winding and 40 turns on the secondary winding. The primary is connected to 300 volt. The primary is connected to 300 volt. The primary is connected to 300 volt 50 hertz supply. The primary is connected to 300 volt 50 hertz supply. Calculate. The primary is connected to 300 volt 50 hertz supply. Calculate. First one. Primary and secondary currents. Primary and secondary current. Second one. Secondary EMF. Third one. Maximum flux. Second one, secondary EMF. Third one, maximum flux. Right. For those who have completed, one more time you solve. Okay. For civil and triple E, I have not covered the problems. At the beginning, only I told some of the problems I have solved for CSE section. But don't worry. One more time you solve. It will be a good practice for you. Now in that case, those who have solved already, solve one more time and tell me the answers. Right? Before that, you have to write given values. What are the values they have given? An ideal 25 kVA. So kVA has given. kVA is equal to how much? 25. Next, has 500 turns on the primary winding. 500 turns on primary means N1 is equal to 500. Okay, NY is equal to 500. Then 40 turns on the secondary. So N2 will be 40 turns. Next, the primary is connected to 300 volt means E1. E1 is equal to how much? E1 is equal to 300 volt. Sorry, E1 is equal to 3000 volt. F is equal to 50 hertz. So what he has asked you to find out? Calculate primary and secondary currents. Primary current means I1. Secondary current means I2. Both formula we already know. What is that? kVA into 1000 divided by V1. kVA into 1000 divided by V2. Tell me the answers of I1 and I2. Abu Ali, where are you? Aap is likh rahe, you are commenting. Everything I remember and come back to you in the class. Calculate. and tell me I1 is equal to how much? Tanya, this is already completed. No, tell me the answers of I1 and I2. I1 is equal to how much? 8.33. I2. Okay. I1 is equal to 8.33 ampere. I2 is equal to correct 104 point how much? 12 ampere. Right. 104.12. Next, secondary EMF how much? Yes, 125. Okay, then secondary EMF E2 is equal to how much? 2 here? You can use EMF equation formula also, or you can use transformation ratio. E2 by E1 is equal to I1 by I2. But E1 has given 3000. Therefore, E2 will be equal to I1 into E1 divided by I2. Okay. E2 is equal to I1 divided by I2. So I1 is how much? 8.33. E1 is 3000 divided by I2 is 104.125. Tell me the answer. E2 is how much? Yes. इमरोज कहाँ रे तूफान के जैसा आ गया है नहीं तो E2 इज इक्वल 240 वोल्ट ओके यस E2 इज इक्वल 240 नेक्स्ट मैक्सिमम फ्लक्स थर्ड वन फ्लक्स मींस 5 एम 5 एम इज इक्वल टू हाउ यू विल कैलकुलेट 5 एम 5 m is having two formula. One is bm into a, but here no, both are not given. So one more is using emf equation, any emf, either e1 or e2, anyone you can use. Therefore 5 m is equal to e1 divided by 4.44 f n1. E1 is again 3000, 4.44 50, n1 is how much? 500. N1 is 500. To find what is the answer? Flux answer. Flux is good. 27. What is the unit? 27 milliweber it is. Okay. Right. So those who have not solved along with me, note down. ಟೈಮ್ ಎಷ್ಟಾಗ್ಯಾದ್ರಿ? ಏ ಮಮ್ಮಿ, ಹಾಂ ಆಯ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಮಮ್ಮಿ ಎಲ್ಲ. ಜರಾ ಬಾಟಲ್ ತ ಬಾಟಲ್ ಬಾಟಲ್ ತ ಜರಾ ನಾ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದಾಯ್ತು. ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 27 ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್ ಓರ್ಲಿ. 0.027 ಇಸ್ ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 27 ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋ ಯು ದಿ 1000 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಯು 027. ಸೊ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಡೆಸಿಮಲ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಡಿಜಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್? 3 ನೋ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ 27, 3 ಡಿಜಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಟು 10⁻³ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ 27 10⁻³ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಮಿಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿಲಿ ವೆಬರ್. ಸಬ್ಸೆ ಬಡಾ ಕರೋನಾ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಮೇ ಛೇ ಭಾಯಿ. ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಲ್ ಕೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪೆ ಕರೋನಾ ದೌಡ್ ರಹಾ ಹೈ. ಮಿಲಿ ಕೋ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಕರ್ನೆ ನೇ ಆತಾ, ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಕೋ ಮಿಲಿ ಕರ್ನೆ ನೇ ಆತಾ ತುಮ್ ಲೋಗೋ. ಚಲೋ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫೇಸ್ 20 ಕೆ ವಿ ಎ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫೇಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ 4. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಾಲ್ವಿಂಗ್ 4 ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಟ್ವೆಂಟಿ ಕೆ ವಿ ಎ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫೇಸ್ 20 kVA transformer has 1000 primary turns and 2500 secondary turns. Has 1000 primary turns and 2500 secondary turns. In 2500 secondary turns, 2500 second turns, the net cross sectional area of the core is full stop. The net cross sectional area of the core is The net cross sectional area of the core is 100 centimeter square. The next cross sectional area of the core is 100 centimeter square. Full stop. When the primary winding is connected to 500 volt, when primary winding is connected to 500 volt, when the primary winding is connected to 500 volt, 50 hertz supply, 50 hertz supply, when the primary winding is connected to 500 volt, 50 hertz supply, calculate first one, maximum value of the flux. Calculate maximum value of flux density. Maximum value of flux density. Second one, voltage induced in the secondary winding. Voltage induced in secondary winding. Third one, primary and secondary currents. Primary and secondary currents. This is the problem. He has given the problem. Again, method. After seeing the problem, read out the problem first, 2 times, 3 times, for better understanding the problem. After that, you have to note down the given values. Solution given. What are the values given here? Single phase. What are the given values here? We already solved 3 problems. Tell me one by one, what are the values given here? Read the problem and tell me. Those who have written, they will tell. Those who have not written, they will not tell. In that case, nobody has written the problem. Good. KV is equal to 20. Okay, next. KV is equal to 20. Next. Very good. N1 is equal to 1000. To keep the intersection interesting, only I'm taking the problems in between to create more interesting. I'm cracking the jokes. It's not like it's simply cracking the jokes, just to get your attention. I'm doing this, guys, so you also show some interest in class. Different scenario will be there, at least in video classes. So many things are happening outside. The whole world is in under threat of corona. That also we are teaching you, means show some interest. I'm happy that so many are interested, so many are showing, so many are involving this session. I'm happy compared to others. 100 centimeter square. Convert that into meter square. How much it will be? N2 is equal to how much? 2500. Area is 100 centimeter square. But area is always in meter. To convert that into meter, how much it will be? To convert that into meter, how much it will be? 100 into centimeter square means centimeter is 10 to the power of minus 2. Square is given. Again, we have to make it square. So it will be 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter. Okay. This is a, we have to convert that into meter. 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Next, what he has given? He has given 500. What is this 500 volt? The primary winding is connected to 500 volt. Therefore, E1 is equal to 500 volt. F is equal to 50 hertz. Right. Now come to the things which we need to calculate. First, maximum value of flux density. Maximum value of flux density. Flux density is BM. BM is equal to phi divided by A. Phi, how much? Phi he has given? No. Then how will calculate phi? A he has given. 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4. How will calculate phi? If anybody has calculated, tell me. 1. Use any one EMF equation. Using any one EMF equation, you can calculate flux. So E1 is equal to 4.44. If I formula also, I only give you what you guys will do. It is already fourth formula. You should identify which formula we have to use to calculate flux. 4.45 f N1. E1 is given, N1 is given, F is given. You can calculate, you calculate phi. Therefore, phi is equal to E1 divided by 4.44 f n1. Even is how much? 500. 4.44 into 50 into n1 is 1000. So how much it will be? Flux is equal to 2.25 milliweber. Got. Flux is equal to 2.25 milliampere. Okay, correct. 2.25 milliweber. Therefore, BM is equal to 2.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 divided by area is how much? 100 into 10 to the power of minus 4. How much you will get? This minus 4, if it goes to numerator, plus 4, it will be plus 4 minus 3 plus 1. 2.25 into 10 divided by 100. It will be 2.25 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by 100. So 22.5 divided by 100. How much? BM is how much? How much? Calculate. 0.2252 Weber per meter square. If you remove these two zeros, you have to add 225. Okay. So if you divide this, you will get 0.2252 Weber per meter square. Next, what he has asked? voltage induced in secondary winding. Voltage induced in secondary winding. Secondary winding means E2. So E2 is equal to how much? You can use EMF equation formula, or you can use E2 by E1 is equal to N2 by N1 formula also you can use. So therefore E2 is equal to N2 E1 divided by N1. N2 is how much? 2500. E1 is 500 divided by N1, 1000. So how much? These two zero cancels, these two zero cancels, this zero cancel, this zero cancel. 250 into 5, how much? 1250. This is simple calculation. Tell me how much you will get. How much? What is the value of E2? 1250 volt. Right. Next, what he has asked, primary and secondary currents. Again, same. I1 is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V1. And I2 is equal to KVA into 1000 divided by V2. KVA is how much? 20 into 1000 divided by V1 is just now. So V1 is 500. I2 20 into 1000 divided by V2 is just now we calculated 1250. Now tell me I1 and I2. How much? Good. 40 is I1 or I2? 40 is I1 value. Correct. I2? I2. Wrong answer. 200 is wrong. 40 is correct. I2? How much? I2 is equal to 16. Okay. Denominator is 500 for I1. For I2, 1250. Okay. I2 is 16. So this is the fourth problem solution. So this is the last problem. This completes all the problems of transformers. Simple problems and somewhat difficult problems also I have taken. So not more difficult they will ask in the exam, only medium problems. First year level only they will ask. So once again I'm telling, this is the easiest topic to score the marks in the problem. Until as you solve the problem, you will not pass. So this is easiest problem. Easiest topic. So thanks for joining the video. So I'll be signing off. Before signing off, once again I am telling you, please write your roll number along with the branch in the comment section, and please make sure that no multiple entries should be there in the comment box. One time you have typed the roll number means that's it. No need to type it again and again. Okay, roll number and branch, don't type multiple times. Okay, bye, take care, good night, we'll meet in the next session. Bye bye.